हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू स्टडी स्मार्ट फॉर कॉम्पिटिशंस। आज डे 10 में हमारा जो टॉपिक है वो है रेशियो, प्रोपोर्शन एंड वेरिएशन। सो इट इज आल्सो एन इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक। यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट 1-2 क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक। सो वी विल टॉक अबाउट प्रॉब्लम्स, काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स वी आर फेसिंग इन IBPS फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक, रेशियो, प्रोपोर्शन एंड वेरिएशन। बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू अवर चैनल फॉर कंटिन्यूअसली गेटिंग अपडेट्स टू अवर चैनल। So hit the subscribe button and hit the bell button so that you can get continuously updates to our channel Study Smart for Competitions. So along with that, I would like to tell you is that all the material PDF and videos will be available on Telegram app also. So how to join Telegram app and all those information is available in our video for how to join Telegram. So you can get this video by navigating to our channel Study Smart for Competitions. And we will start with our topic, ratio, proportion and variations. So some common concepts, we will start with some common concepts that if a proportion is given as 1 over a over b, so it can also be written as ma over mb. So like we have a ratio as 1 by 2, so if we will multiply it with 2 for with both with denominator and denominator, like 1 by 2 multiplied by 2 multiply by 2, then it will be 2 by 4. So 2 by 4 again it is 1 by 2. So multiplying it with m doesn't make any difference. So coming to concept number 2 is that like if we have a ratio like a over b, then a divided by d divided by b divided by d will also be equal. Let's suppose that we have same example, we have 2 by 4 with us and we are dividing it with 2. So the value of d here is 2 and it will be 1 over 2. So this is like same thing, and we are going to use this concept in our question. The type of question which is appeared in previous year IBPS exam. So everybody knows this concept but do not know how to use this concept. So our first problem is that A started a business with a sum of ₹14,000. So there were guy A who have started a business with a sum of ₹14,000. After 4 months, B entered with an amount of ₹12,000. So after 4 months, B entered the business and A added 2,000 in the business. So after 2 months, A also added additionally 2,000 into the business. So after 6 months, C entered with ₹20,000 and B withdrew 2,000 from the business. So it is like B is entered into the business after 4 months and after 6 months he is withdrawing 2,000. So this is the like I will tell you how to solve this type of problems. First we will dictate what the question says. So like what will be the C's share of profit out of the total profit. So here is the given as total profit 94,000 at the end of 2 years. So after a duration of 2 years, what would be C share. So here we have to find the proportion of investment by C. If we will find the proportion of C into the business, we can easily find what would be the profit of C. So here like we are going to find the proportion of C investment into the business. So how we will approach this problem is that like here we will write A, B, C and here would be tenure. So A started with his business with ₹14,000 at the start of the business. Now after a duration of 4 months, B entered with amount as 12,000. So like after a gap of 4 months, B entered the business with 12,000 and A added 2,000 in the business. So A added 2,000. So A total investment after 4 months would be 16,000. Now after 6 months, C entered with ₹20,000. So he is talking after 6 months from the starting. So if we will write here, it will be 2 months. 4 plus 2, 6 months. So after 6 months, C entered into the business and invested ₹20,000. And B withdrew ₹2,000 and it will be 10,000 left. It would be 10,000 left. So we will write the net amount that would be left at that moment. So like, what will be the C's share of the profit of total profit as 94,000 after a duration of 2 years? So 6 months are already passed. So they are talking about after 18 months, like 18 plus 6, 24, and it will be 2 years. So they are talking about what would be C share after 2 years. So in order to find C share, we will need to find what would be the investment proportion of C here. So C has invested 20,000 after 6 months. So this kind of questions, let me draw this picture on the next page. $14,000, he started the business, and after 4 months A added additionally 2,000, so the total now will be 16,000, and B invested after only 4 months, so it would be 12,000, and now after 6 months, total 6 months, and but it would be 4 plus 2, 6 months, B invested, B have withdrawn 2,000, and the net amount left in the business is 10,000, and B, C additionally entered with 20,000. Now they have asked what would be the C's share in profit after 2 years, 18 plus 6, 24 months. So the equation we will write here is that, like, 14,000, 20,000, we have to contribute the C share. So 20,000 for a period of 18 years divided by proportion. The proportion would be, like, starting from A, 14,000 multiplied by 4 plus 16,000 multiplied by 20, and we will write down here at for B now. So for B, it would be 12,000 for 2 months and 10,000 for the rest of 18 months. And now C, because in total profit C share will also be counted. So this is the approach we will follow it in order to approach this problem. So like, there are big figures, and you will find it hard to solve this problem. So here is a technique, ratio technique. Like I told you that if A over B is equals to A by D and B by D, so you can just divide every amount here by 1,000, because if we will divide 1,000 every figure here, there would be no change in the proportion, because A by B will be equal to A by D upon B by D. So like, if we, I will divide it by 1,000, it would make no any difference. So we can also do it with the tenure also. Like, if I divide my tenure with, like, I have to divide whole of the tenures, like 2 can be divided from each of these tenures. Like, I can divide 2 here, 2 here, 2 here also. So this the approach to reduce this equation, because this equation is hard to solve. You can find your answers by solving this equation as well, but I'm trying to tell you a short method to solve this type of question. You can also divide 2 from each of this figure. So I think you have understood, whatever you are dividing, you have to divide from each of the figure here, and you have to divide, if you are dividing tenure also, you have to divide from each of the term. So I have divided that terms that can easily be divisible into a perfect number, into a natural number. So I have divided the tenure here with 2, not with 4, because like it would be a natural number after dividing this. So like we are going to write this equation into the simple form. So now this term will be like 7. 7 like we will write it for C first, because we need to find the proportion of C. For C it would be 10, and for a duration of 9. And for A, starting from A, we will find the A's share. It would be 7 for a month of 2 plus 8 for a month of 1, and starting with like also like it would be 8 also, like I have in previously I have added 18 plus 20 together. So here if I will write 2 9 the 18, 2 1 the 1, so it would be 10 here. 9 plus 1, 9 plus 1 for total A's investment, like he would be investing 16,000 for 20 months, and he would be investing 8 for 10. Now I will write for B. For B it would be like 1000 cut and 6 multiply by for a duration of 1, and it would be 5 multiply by duration of 9. Now C it would be same figure, 10 like 1000 cut, and it would be 10 left, and 10 multiply by 9. Now we will solve this equation. Now this equation is much more easy to solve than this equation, but you have to be careful how to divide all these quantities with the common factors. Like out of all these figures, the common factor is 1002, so I have divided with all these figures with 2000 and the tenure with 2. That is a common factor of all these tenures. So I have to write a plus here. I have forgot to write it, because it would be the sum of all the profits from each person A, B and C. So I will calculate this, and you have to calculate this also to find out that the both answers getting by this would be same. So if we will proceed with the calculation of this, it would be 90 divided by 14 plus 80 plus 6 plus 45 plus 90, and multiply it with the total profit. The total profit was 94,000. If we will multiply the C proportion with total profit, we will get the proportion of the C profit. It would be 94,000. So let us just add these figures. What I will find out is that here it would be 94 and 100 and 190 and 235. So after solving this, what you would find that your answer would be approximately 36,000. So try solving this equation as well and find out what would be the answer if you will not apply this common factor thing. So this question was also easy. Like I have written 14,000, 16,000, 12,000, 10,000 and 20,000 after the durations whatever the question told me, and I have write down into our equation, and I have also written down in the simple terms, answers would be same. So you can try this technique solving this question easily and fastly in your examination. So moving ahead with our next questions is that ratio of A salary to B salary is 2:3. Like A salary to B is 2:3, and B to C salary, ratio of B salary to C salary is 4:5, and what is the ratio of A is to C? We have to find out what would be the ratio of A is to C. So the normal method I would like to tell you the normal method here, and I would like to tell you the short method here. So the normal method would be 2, 3, 4 and 5. In order to equate A and C here, you have to multiply with this term with both of this, like you have to multiply it with 4, and here you have to multiply it with 3, so that B can be common and A and C proportion can be found out. So if we will multiply 4 it with, it would be 8 and 24, and here in this case it would be 12 and 15. So A is to B is to C would be 8, 12, 15. So this is the method, general method that you can use. So A is to C would be 8 is to 15. Now the shortcut method for that would be, is that if you have to find in such cases A is to B is to C, what you will do is that for A you will multiply these terms, 2 multiplied by 4. For B, you will multiply this term with this term, 3 multiplied by 4. And for C, you will multiply these terms, 3 multiplied by 5. So it would be 8, 12 and 15. The answer would be same. So I will explain it with the bigger problem also. If you are getting like A is to B, B is to C, C is to D and D is to E, and you are asked what would be A is to E. In those questions, what you will do is that you will find A is to B is to C is to D is to E, and that would be like for A it would be 2 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 12, and for B is, it is 3 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 12, and for C it would be 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 12. And for D, it would be 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 12. And for E, it would be 3, 5, 11 and 17. So you can multiply all this equation and you will get A is to B is to C is to D is to E, and the first and last term would be A is to E. So this is the technique you can follow to identify what would be ratio of E is to E. So moving ahead with our next questions. So if we are given with the two equations and three variables X, Y and Z, and we have to identify X, Y, Z. So we will identify this kind of things with this below equation. So the equation is given here as a1x plus b1y plus c1z equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2z equal to 0. So the x would be b1 c2 minus b2 c1 and y would be c1 a2 minus c2 a1 and z would be a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is the proportion of x is to y is to z. So you can easily identify x is to y is to z with this formula. So we are going to apply this formula to this question also. So x ratio would be 3 multiplied by 7 minus 24 is to like 4 multiplied by 5 minus 14, and z would be like a1 b2 2 multiplied by 6 minus 5 multiplied by 3, 15. So this would be the ratio of x, y and z. It would be minus 3, 6 and minus 3, and it comes out to be minus 1, 2, minus 1. So that would be your answer. You will find out and you will directly tick into your options. So we will see another type of ratio and proportions. So these kind of questions you might have seen in your examinations, in your mock test, that you have given with the ratio of water and milk, and you have to identify what amount of water should be added so that the final ratio would be this. So this kind of problem I have written here. The ratio of वाटर एंड मिल्क इज 30 liters, मिक्सचर इज 7:3. Find the quantity of water to be added to the mixture. So, in order to make the ratio as 6:1. So, the initial ratio is 7:3 and the total mixture is 30 liters. So, in this, we have to identify what would be the ratio of milk and water. So, originally, the ratio of milk was ratio of water and milk was 7:3 and ratio of milk would be 3 divided by sum of these two. 10, 7 plus 3 and multiply by total quantity, that is 30 liters, it would be 9 liters. So it was 9 liter milk and 30 liters minus 9 liters, 21 liters water. So we can also verify that 21 by 9 is 7 by 3, which was the ratio given to us. So this is the ratio initially. This was the quantity of water present and this was the quantity of milk present. So what quantity of water should be added so that the ratio would be 6:1? So in order to make the ratio of water and milk as 6:1, we have identified that we have 9 liters of milk. So the in order to make it 9, we will multiply both with it with 9. So the final quantity that would be containing 54 liters of water and 9 liters of milk. So the ratio would be 6:1. In order to make 54 liters of water, we already have 21 liters. We will add 21 plus 6 equals to 54. That would comes out to be 33. And that is your answer C. So in this way, you can proceed with this kind of questions. So three containers A, B, C are having mixtures of milk and water. So another example for milk and water, because these kind of questions are really important in terms of your IBPS PU examination. So milk and mixtures are in the ratio of 1:5, 3:5 and 5:7 in three containers having milk and water in the ratio of 1:5, 3:5 and 5:7. But the capacities of three different containers are in the ratio of 5, 4 and 5. So again, the capacities are different. So they say that if we will mix them together, all the three containers, what would be the final ratio of milk to water? So what would be the final ratio of milk to water if mixtures of all the three containers are mixed together? So these kind of problems, you have to assume the capacity of containers. So the capacity of container is 5:4:5. So you will assume that the first container capacity is 500 liter and second container capacity is 400 liter and third container capacity is 500 liters. So if in the first container whose ratio is 1:5, you have to identify the ratio of milk. Ratio of milk would be 1/6, 1/1+5 into 500. That would be ratio of milk in our container first. And in container second, which is 3:5, our quantity of milk would be 3/3+5, 8 multiplied by total capacity of the container. And in container number 3, whose ratio of milk and water is 5:7, the ratio of what milk would be 5/7+5, 12 × 500. So you will identify your capacities, quantities of milk in all these three containers, and you can easily identify your quantity of water as well, because total quantity, you know, it would be 1400 liters. So my capacity of quantity of milk minus total quantity, that would be quantity of water. So here what I will evaluate is that 500 by 6 would be 100 by 6 would be 16.66 and it would be multiplied by 5, that comes out to be 83.33. So we will calculate 3 by 8 multiplied by 400 here, 2 for the 8, 200, 50, and it comes out to be 150, 50 multiplied by 3. So the quantity of milk in second container would be 150 out of 400. And the third would be 5 by 12 multiplied by 500. That comes out to be Now, if you will calculate this, three for the 12 and three one the three. Multiply by 5, that would comes out to be 208.3. So if you will have to identify the quantity of water in the mixture, so you will add all these quantities, and 1400 minus this quantity, that would be quantity of your water. So here it is 208.3 in container 3 and container 2 quantity would be, it would be it would be 150 and 83.33, it would comes out to be 441.63. So you will divide it with, minus it with 1400, that is the total quantity of the container, total capacity of the three containers. So it would be approximately 66, and it comes out to be 339 and 5. And it would comes out to be 13 and 9. So the ratio would be milk to water is this ratio, 441.66 is to total quantity of water, 959.33. So in order to solve this, here it comes out to be 8. So in order to solve this, what you will identify is that, so you can write it as 441 plus 0.66, as we have also explained in our simplification tricks. You will follow the same method. You will write it as 958 plus 0.33. So 0.66 can be written it as 441 plus 2 by 3 and 958 plus 1 by 3. So in order to make it whole numbers, what you will do, it is with, is multiplying this number as with 3 and this number also with 3. So this comes out to be 441 multiplied by 3 plus 2, ratio 958 multiplied by 3 plus 1. So you will solve it, that comes out to be 13 plus 2, ratio 3 8 to 24 3 5 to 15 17 and 2 8 7 4 plus 1. So the final ratio that you will calculate is that 3 1 3 2 5 and 2 8 7 5. And one thing you need to understand, it is that if you are getting 25 and 75 as your last digit, it would be definitely be divided with 25. So divide these terms with 25 and you will get your final proportion, and you will find that option in your four multiple options. So that comes out to be 53, and here it would be 53. This would be your final answer. So this how you can try your questions, that comes out to be 115. So in this how you can solve your questions, and these are the techniques for ratio and proportion. If you have liked the video, एंड कीप्स डू सब्सक्राइब टू अवर चैनल एंड इफ यू वांट टू गेट कॉन्टिन्यूस अपडेट्स टू अवर वीडियोस सो हिट द बेल आइकन एंड यू विल गेट द इम्पोर्टेंट अपडेट्स. वी आर कंप्लीटिंग अवर 14 डेज क्रैश कोर्स फॉर IBPS सो स्टे ट्यून्ड विद अस. थैंक यू सो मच गाइज़.